guys, welcome to today's video. And today we have a vlog trip because it is Labor Day weekend and, well, I feel like doing a vlog. So right now we're traveling through New Mexico and we're heading to Bayfield in Colorado. So we've been on the road for, let's see, 8 hours, exactly 8 hours at this point. So yeah, it's been a long day so far, but we were able to get out 15 minutes earlier than what we had planned. So yeah,
we got lots of stuff,
but it should be fun. It's gonna be nice up there, but driving through New Mexico has been interesting, and it's been raining a lot for a lot of the time. Right now it's not raining, it like just stopped raining, so yeah,
but as you can see,
there are still, yeah, clouds around. So yep, we just got rid of it. We were going away to get away from the rain, like, and go visit. To get away from the rain and go visit. That's what we were doing. But that didn't work so well. But yeah.
So the golf course.
Lots of patches of green.
Big patches of green down there.
But yeah. So we 19 miles left to go here, and then we will turn. I don't know. Where what we turn to?
Lake Vallecito.
Yeah, no, yeah, we will end up in Lake Vallecito. But yeah, we just gotta head to Bayfield so we can get there. Pretty interesting day so far. Yes. So whenever the next clip will be, that's when I'll see you again. It started raining really hard. It's really loud. They're really big drops.
Really?
They're really, really big. Yeah, all we wanted to do was to get away from this. My goodness. This is bit crazy. This is ridiculous. But yeah, so now we're heading to Vallecito Lake, where we need to go. So guess we'll see you there.
I laid one down at
Okay, so little situation. We did not get where we were supposed to go. We went just about 40 miles out of the way and almost killed a deer. So that was great. We have burning rubber. We are burning rubber. Probably have bald tires.
The deer's still alive.
Yeah, the deer's still alive. Yeah.
Everything back here just went flying forward.
My phone was somewhere under there. I found it eventually. And if I was recording that, my camera would have hit the windshield. It would have flew out of my hands and went, whee! So, yeah. That was interesting. Now we gotta go all the way back. And, yeah. There was one road, I didn't know what it was. And it was the road we were supposed to go on. And the maps just wouldn't tell me. The map that we have in the glove box wouldn't tell me. We didn't really have any service. So we had to go back on the, whatever it was, 160. We just thought, oh, we'll just go back on the 160, and then that's where we're supposed to go. Nope. So, yeah. And we are tired of this rain. It's still raining. Again, and then again, and then again, and then, yeah, it just keeps raining. I don't know why, but, yeah, so, this is interesting. We don't know how we did it, but we did. So, now we'll see you when we get where we need to be.
Sioux City Sue. Your hair is red, your eyes are blue. I swap my horse and dog for you. Sioux City Sue. There ain't no gal as true as my sweet Sioux City Sue. All together now. Sioux City Sue. Your hair is red, your eyes are blue. I swap my horse and dog for you. Sioux City Sue. There ain't no gal as true as my sweet Sioux City Sue.
San Juan summer back in 1881. She was the beautiful daughter of the DNRG. She weighed about 1,000 tons. It was 45 miles through the Animas Canyon. They sat her on a narrow gauge. She drank a whole lot of water, ate a lot of coal. They called her the Silverton, Silverton train. Here comes the Silverton up from Durango. Here comes the Silverton shoveling coal. From the Silverton up from the canyon, see the smoke and hear the whistle blow. The whistle through the rock wood cut on the high line to Silverton town.
Oh, that's a train!
You're gonna get a shiver when you check out the river. It's 400 feet straight down. Well, you take on some water at the Needleton tank. Struggle up a 2-5 grade. By the time you get your hide through the snow sheds, like you've had a ride on the Silverton train.
Here comes the Silverton up from Durango. Here comes the Silverton shuttling. Here comes the Silverton up from the canyon. See the smoke and hear the whistle blow. Silverton up from Durango. Here comes the Silverton shoveling coal. Here comes the Silverton up from the canyon. See the smoke and hear the whistle blow.
Down by the station early in the morning, there's a whole lot of people in line. They've all bought a ticket on a train to yesterday, and it's gonna leave on time. It's 45 miles through the Animas Canyon. They sat her on a narrow gauge. She drinks a whole lot of water, eats a lot of coal. They call her the Silverton.
Hey guys, we made it. So we made it to here last night. Gotta get some stuff out of the car. It's been raining again. So, stuff out of here. I think this is an all-wheel drive. Okay, so I need to get Bray up. He's down for a minute. Yeah, so we went to a dinner last night that we had a reservation for. It was cool. I got a clip of that and I just used my camera until the batteries had died. So I got new batteries in it. We're good to go. Just the other, wait, shoot. I think those are the same. I believe those are the same. She likes it there. She probably wants these. I'm thinking she wants these. Thank you. I don't know. Yes, now I gotta close the car. Right. It's an all-wheel drive car. So yeah, so now we're just gonna drive around a bit, maybe go on the lake if we can. It's a beautiful day though. And yeah, so I don't know when the next time we'll see you guys.
Wow, what a view.
You know what, let's get out. Well, no, last time it's too bad.
It's amazing. It's already been 15 years since
the 15-year anniversary of 9/11.
Yeah,
it's been which is crazy that we still have to know about this, and it's part of our everyday lives now. Terrorism is a big fear, even though everybody says don't be afraid of terrorists, because if you're afraid, that's what people want. That's what terrorists want you to feel. But still, it's
but
terror.
It's hard to get through it. It's hard to do that.
Especially if you lose somebody. Lose a family member or lose a friend. It sucks.
And a lot of people out there, you know, after that, there's a lot of people out there that say that will encourage you to, you know, stand up for yourself. And if anything happens like that, just do whatever you can do. If you know there's something you can do, then we just encourage you to do it.
You know, and I couldn't imagine being on live TV or even in Manhattan and seeing that first, the South Tower fall. Like, that must have been so scary, knowing that we're going to be at war. It's going to happen. This is the end of the world, and